in the near future. Today's recitalist is Christopher Keady. Christopher is Grace Cathedral's Assistant Director of Music and the principal organist for our choir of men and boys. If you're interested in reading more about Chris or seeing the program and the program notes, please look for that link on our website. Please join us next month on March 7th when our recitalist will be Brett Judson. We really rely on your support to make this world-class organ recital series happen, so I hope you'll consider giving a gift today. You can click the donate button on your screen, or you can text the word GRACE to 76278. Thank you so much for your support. And we're so glad that you're here today and that you're watching. And now please join me in welcoming Christopher Keady.
Good afternoon, and thank you so much for joining me for this recital. I'm very pleased that so many people are able to hear this wonderful instrument and music due to our, it's a silver lining of our current quarantine situation. So thank you again for tuning in, and I hope you enjoyed Percy Whitlock's Plymouth Suite. It's a wonderful kind of English romantic, almost pastoral, but like a pastoral version of seafaring culture, that sort of thing. And as you may have read in the program notes, I hope you'll check them out if you haven't. Whitlock was a municipal organist, meaning his primary job was to entertain people, not necessarily to accompany worship services. He was the organist at the Bournemouth Pavilion in the south of England. And so you can hear that kind of theatrical quality in his music. The next few pieces I'm going to play, it's a pair from a larger set by Ethel Smyth. And she was a somewhat one generation earlier than Whitlock, but a nonetheless a romantic composer. You can read more about her in the program notes again. But these are, I think, are wonderfully expressive works that take a German chorale tune and kind of surround it with interesting new material. The second one in particular is just extremely emotional to me, and it really captures the spirit of our Good Friday liturgies that we celebrate here in the Episcopal Church during Holy Week, just kind of a meditative and mournful quality. And lastly, I'll be playing a wonderfully exciting sonata by Basil Harwood. We have very British names on this program, Percy and Basil. Harwood was a almost exact contemporary of Ethel Smyth, but primarily a church musician. And he seems to have let out all of his creativity in his solo organ music. This is quite wild music that wouldn't really be suited to a worship service. But again, wonderfully expressive and almost kind of an orchestral conception of the organ. So thank you again for joining me and for listening, and I hope you enjoy Ethel Smyth's two chorale preludes and Basil Harwood's organ sonata number 1.